Everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we're playing Life is Strange Before the Storm, finally. I know some people have been waiting and I am so excited to play this beautiful, amazing game. Okay, and we're gonna play as Chloe, which I've kind of been waiting for. Honestly, I love Chloe so much. Obviously, we all know what I did in the last episode of Life is Strange. I'm not gonna talk about it. You can go watch it if you want to. But yeah, this is before the storm, before the tornado. Right, oh, the tornado, right? I'm hoping I'm right. I kind of forgot. Oh god. Okay. But yeah, this is part one of my Life is Strange Before the Storm playthrough. Hopefully you guys all enjoy. Also, I love the music for this home screen one. It is so pretty. This has the most beautiful music ever. And yeah, I'm probably gonna be copyrighted in this playthrough, so it's really sad, but you know. I gotta like play as young Chloe and the newly remastered people of like, Uncover the Dark Secrets of Arcadia Bay. Okay. I'm nervous, but I hope you guys all enjoy the first part of my Life is Strange Before the Storm playthrough. Part one. Oh god, okay. Hopefully everything's good. Oh my god. Awake, and that looks like Rachel Amber right there. So, bonus episode. Oh my god, there's only three of them too, and I'm pretty sure they're very long episodes, so buckle up everyone. Not gonna lie, I'm nervous, so let's get started. Episode one, Awake. Oh, and oh my god, the bird in the corner. That is so cool. This is already so different because Chloe is so different from Max, obviously. The Life is Strange Before the Storm is a turn-based game. It features players' choice and consequences of your actions and decisions will impact the world around you. Choose wisely, dot dot dot. I will try to choose wisely. Oh! Is that our Chloe? Younger Chloe, though. Not like 18 or 19 or whatever age she was before. Oh, a cloud. Oh my god, I am nervous, but our first playthrough of this beautiful game, let's see how it goes. You really like your train track.
I can't believe Firelock is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Oh, she's so cute.
Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Girl, why are you out here then? Oh my god. Oh my god. We're Chloe, everyone. We're finally Chloe. I love Chloe so much. She looks so different from when she, like, blue hair. If she has brown hair right now. She looks all normal and everything. Not really that emo yet. She kind of looks like kind of she wants to be emo. Okay, let's go. She's getting impatient with us. We're in Arcadia Bay too. I wonder where we are in Arcadia Bay right now. But we can run. Kind of. Not really. It's like a really quick, like. Is it a firefly? Oh my god. I'm pretty sure it's a firefly right there. Oh my god. It's so cool. Okay. I'm too excited, everyone. So sorry. Okay, I guess the only thing we can look at is this little fence right here. Uh-oh. It's different. Oh my god, okay. Approach the fence, hold, and then S to jump it. Oh my god, okay.
No trespassing?
That's
no
different.
Way.
Different mechanics. I didn't think that there would be. And then S to jump. Okay. No trespassing, Chloe. Oh, okay. Clearly she likes flipping off signs.
Holy shit.
Inanimate objects? Oh, are we going to like a band? Oh my god.
This place is awesome.
Did she say firewalk? I'm pretty sure that's literally what she just said.
If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Okay. There are so many things around. Machinery. There's people over, there's cars everywhere, and there's a guy right there. Oh my god. What are we gonna look at first? There's fireflies everywhere. Oh my god, it's so pretty. I've actually never noticed that in some of the playthroughs I've seen of this game, so whoa. I'm so freaking excited to play this finally for myself! Like, my dream is coming true of being able to play Life is Strange. Because I love these games so freaking much. Okay. We can't really look at any of these cars, so that's awkward. Sadly enough. Alright. Oh, okay, I gotta remember it's W now.
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
Oh, we're at the mill. Oh my god. It's so ancient. I need to not say Max. I'm so like used to saying Max and I'm playing Life is Strange, so it's Chloe.
Not mine.
Oh, they're arguing? Oh, betting sub. What?
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
Oh my god. Lost $1,000? I would be doing that too, Chloe. What the hell? I would cry. Oh god, wait. W.
Some say the world will end in fire.
Will it though? It might. Like Terminator. Gas can.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Clearly not. God. Gonna blow up? Oh no. Oh, the wheels forever? Okay, whatever that means. RV! Is this Frank's RV? It kind of looks like Frank's RV. Maybe it's not.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
He's the only one that ever had a. Oh, she wants a graffiti? Like on these? Oh. Look at the fireflies! There's so many. I love it. What the hell? Oh no, we're on a graffiti. Chloe, this is not a good idea.
Perfect place for me to work.
Okay, let's graffiti some stuff for her. Clearly she's a graffitier.
Now what to draw?
Not a meth lab free candy. Definitely not a meth lab. That's like, that's the best one. No, this is a meth lab. Totally not.
Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab.
Oh my god, I love her. Oh, she has a journal? Wait, where's the tab button? I don't know where the tab button is. I'm so sorry. Right there. Oh! Oh my god, she writes too? I'm so scared to write what she has to say because she's gone through so much already. Dear Max? Oh my god, okay. We're in 2010, so that's like 3 years earlier, maybe, I think. Alright, I'm gonna read this. I'm sorry, everyone, I'm bad at reading. If you watched my Life is Strange playthrough of the first one, I would not want to listen to me right now, but you can if you want. Dear Max, Dad got me this stationery one day. Wait, what? One day when I complained about wanting to send an email. And the internet was down, and tonight I thought, hey, maybe it's time to write Max. The funny thing is, I don't really know what to say, because we haven't even talked in 3 months. Despite all the my calls and texts, and not that I'm upset or anything, fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe, the unfriended. Oh my god. Yeah, she was we already know she was so hurt from Max never, like, messaging her back or calling her back or anything like that. Yeah, that's kind of all Max, because she could at least, like, texted her or something, like, what the hell? I'm a Chloe side for this, even in the first game, honestly, like, goddamn. Max. Now this is more like it. Here, I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write back to me. Write me back. Maybe one day when we return home and apologize for having forgotten all about me, we kiss and make up. Oh my god, okay. I'll show this to you, and we can read it and laugh. Or maybe I'll decide that Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max. And you'll just live in here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend. Pen pal, time will tell. Time will tell, that's crazy. Okay, Chloe the journal boss. Put your thoughts in me. So she's basically just like kind of writing to Chloe in a way, I guess, in her journal. Which is it's an interesting way to write a journal. Oh, 3/20/2010. Ready? So mom suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm like, cool, I guess. But then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David. Oh my god, we know that David. The wannabe drill surgeon who swooped in on my mom and has stuck around like a bad zit. David, the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That fucking David. Oh my, she really hates him. Oh my god. I mean, like, her dad died, her mom is moving on, she's not over her dad dying. It makes sense, like, it's hard, okay. Anyway, I politely suggested to mom that perhaps it's too early to assume David would be in the picture by then. Or breathing. Oh my god, that's so emo. Hey, shit happens. As you might imagine, that didn't go over well. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, oh god, Chloe, you're in for a ride. Then she's got serious self-esteem issues, and I've got serious self-immolation. Look it up, nerd. Plans. Okay. She can do better, that's all I meant, but she didn't want to hear it, like, I'm the asshole. Chloe the asshole. And the drawing was so cool of her, too. 4/4/2010. So, you know how I stopped going to class so much? Like, you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't show up. And it was fine, nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like then I'm invisible. Or invincible, right? Invincible. All of a sudden, maybe that's the perk of being the dead bad girl. God, no one knows what to do with me, and they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I figured this out sooner and think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Pierce from Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one? What? I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard and that smolder of his, but then Pierce just totally stole the show. Probably nothing there, just think I just want her bangs. Chloe the electric sheep. What in God's name? What? Okay. That's too much information, Chloe. What the hell? That's a lot of information. A Blade Runner, though. I think Chloe and Max watched that in the Fly with Strange One. Okay, that's all of them. Oh, we have our little description. Oh, of William, of her dad? Oh my god. Oh my god, look at those. Why is it gel cells right there? What the hell is she? And worms? Oh my god. Obviously, the middle finger. My name is Clay Price, but you can call me. I am an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently serving a 4-year sentence for crimes against maternity. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me. Which I get it, I'm not one's image of a perfect daughter, or student, or anything really. But who the fuck wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection, and it sucks ass. Other things that suck, mom's new drill sergeant boyfriend David, how hard it is to buy weed around here. Having no friends, hypocrites, country music, people who say chillax, dad being dead. It's been 2 years since he died in a car crash, and I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weird life-like dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times I remember that he's defeating worms in a ditch right now. And anything else is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. Oh my god, she is not doing good. We know that though, we already know that. At least I have 2 weapons to help me survive in this shitberg town. Depend, I use a tag any and everything I want and my shining personality. If I work at it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. Okay. Oh, and Joyce and David. Despite my mom's best efforts, I don't actually hate her. I know shit's been rough since dad died. Money's tight. Her job as a waitress at a diner isn't exactly glamorous. But I'm clearly not all about the whole going to school thing. But why does she have to make things so much harder on both of us? She asks if I She acts like if I smoke pot or when I skip out to go catch an awesome show, it's somehow a personal attack on her. She should be happy that I'm self-medicating and not going postal on everyone. She never used to be this way when Dad was around. She could actually be cool. But lately there's a hairy dick monster. Oh my god. She let into the house that's fucking everything up. David Madison, a jobless, brainless, dickless little shit with a hard-on for the military and a promise to whip me into shape? Asshole. What in the god's name? That's some kind of description for him. What the hell? I've tried to express these concerns to my mom, yet every week it seems the virus spreads to yet another corner of her life. I'm starting to worry that the David flu is the kind of disease that kills its host. Oh god. And the little drawing of that, Jesus Christ. And here we got Maxine. Super Kitty is trapped. We must save her. Meow. Hey Chloe. Max Caulfield, MIA, ex-best friend extraordinaire. This artsy motherfucker loves art photography more than life itself, and definitely more than me. She even uses old Insta cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be that stuck in the past. But who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we would dress up as pirates and eat ice cream and write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and saved people and shit. Then my dad died and her dad got some job up north and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her the most, but she belled. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can rely on it. I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned. Oh, God. Yeah, we know. She's, so mad at her. The worst part is that even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she habitually ignored my text so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore, and that she probably has all new friends up in fucking Seattle, I still miss her. If she came out tomorrow and said, "Hey, Chloe, I want to dress up like pirates and be stupid together," I would take her back in a heartbeat. In a heartbeat. And we know she would. She did take her back, literally, in 3 years, pretty much. Oh my god. Oh god, okay. This is for her dad. If I had a knuckle bag for every jerk-off guidance counselor or therapist who tried to get me to write shit about Dad over the last couple years, I would never have to buy weed from Frank again. What's the matter? You want to write your dear old dad? Oh god. I guess I think it helps me cope with my feelings or whatever. As if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are probably still plastered on the underside of a semi-truck. Oh, and what the fuck am I supposed to write anyway? That he was the perfect dad who always... He was also... Oh, I can't write. I can't say any of this. Oh my god. This is terrible. And who has... Who... I can't speak. He was always fun to be around and never angry. That he treated me like an equal. That he was constantly working to make life better. They could always make me laugh even when I was being a bitch. That he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy. And that his BBQ grill was still rusting in the backyard. Because the thought of either throwing it away or ever using it again are both painful. That is easier for Mom and me to just pretend neither of us notice it. If that's coping, then coping can go fuck itself. Honestly, though. Okay, that's it on that one. Here's a little episode. Oh, I got our little things right here. Definitely, absolutely not a meth lab. Wow, her description on her dad is just so sad. I don't even know what to say. Oh god, I want to look at Max's. Oh god, okay. So sorry, I've been bad at emailing. Texting is better for me anyway. Yo, it's Max. How's it going, you there? Wow, she responded a few days later, okay. Sorry again, I've been really busy. You can close it out more in a bit. And she responds right away. Oh my god, Chloe. Oh yeah, she barely messaged her. Look at this timing. Cool, maybe some hitchhiking in my future. Hey, hippie. I'm so sorry, maybe we should set up a time to call. No worries. Yeah, I'll check my dance card. It's 7 p.m. in Arcadia. What is it, in 2019 in Seattle? I know, right? Maybe this weekend. Sure, anytime, let me know. Yo, Queen of the Crickets. What's the latest? Max? Oh my god, I feel so bad. Look at this. She like mushes. Yeah, Maxine is just such a fucking bad friend. Oh my god. No offense to Max. We love Max, but like Max is not a very good friend. Will you be joining us for supper? No thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Oh god. Who the fuck is this dude? Elliot? Spanish has sucked. Lucky if I pass. Aw. Lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Cool. What you up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Oh, okay. Okay, that's a weird, boring conversation. Oh, he's Frank! Probably about all the drugs. Oh god. Your shit's here. Hell yeah, but tapped out. Sorry. Your loss. Hey, you can hold it for me a day, can I? I'm your favorite customer. Are you? Frank, you holding? You still owe. You gotta have me whacked. Yes, please, a joke about the overtax. You deal drugs on this phone. Anyway, come on, it's 420. I'll meet you if you can have the cash. Alright, rain check. There are a good rain check. Okay, that's all your messages. Not really very many people. Drugs, weird guy, and her mom, and then a girl that doesn't respond to her. So sad. Alright, let's keep playing. I'm sorry it took forever. I'm a really slow reader. But let's get going, Chloe. Let's get into this fucking rave or mosh pit or whatever. Anything else we can look at, though? Oh, dog kennel. Is there a dog somewhere?
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
Oh, bikes. Is there a whole bunch of bikers here?
A second door inside? So close, and yet so far.
Yeah. Listen. Oh my god. Woo!
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
It shreds so hard. Oh my god, okay. We're emo now, guys. Okay.
I'd join a motorcycle gang. If I had any friends.
Would you? Oh, okay. That looks like Spider-Man bike. I mean, not. I'm tripping. Let's run over to these. Can we look at these guys?
Those guys need to get a room.
Oh yeah, they do. Wow.
Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
Why'd you slap him for? What the hell?
I understand. I understand, really. And it won't ever happen again, I swear.
So much drama already.
I promise. I really get it now. I do.
Do you? Because trust with me is earned in actions, not words. Got it?
Oh, God. Okay, that's an interesting conversation. I don't know if it matters for us or not.
Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see
god,
a show.
Oh my god, Chloe. That's probably what you should not have done.
This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home.
Oh my god.
Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
Really? I feel so bad. Oh my god. Any place is better than home. Why? Train car?
An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
Alright, let's talk to this guy. Can we not go up here? No. Can we go, bouncer? Oh, no? Okay.
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Oh, we have to get past him. Okay. Let's speak to him.
Help you, miss?
Yeah, we're just trying to
go. You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
I'm totally legit. Totally.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Why? What the hell? Even though this is really not a safe place for her, honestly, he's right.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
The bike? Can the bike convince him? What is wrong with the bike?
Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
What's wrong with floral prints? What the hell, Chloe? Anything else you can see? Not betting sub. I'm not exactly sure if there's anything else. There's fireflies everywhere. Why can't we just go look at the fireflies instead, Chloe? Okay, I don't think there's anything else, honestly. Yeah, let's just talk to this guy then. Try to,
know. What do you want, kid?
We just
want
to see the band. Oh, let me sit. Let me inside now. Your bike, walk away, the mill.
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
What's wrong with it?
It's, pretty cool.
Oh.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
The mill?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
What, she just wants to see Firewalk?
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Oh no, I'm scared about the top option. We don't want to walk away. We probably had to... Sort of a backtalk challenge. Oh no.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
I'm not good at things like this. And backtalk uses arguments and insults to get someone to do what he wants.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this.
Oh no. What if we lose?
Is it past your bedtime?
Bedtime. Is it past your bedtime? No bedtime. Do me a solid. Your bedtime?
Aw, isn't it past yours?
What the hell?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Cute. Real cute, but I still don't know you. I don't do cute. Cute is relative. What could hurt?
Look at my face.
Oh god, we're being really emo.
Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it.
We're really tough. This is a playground, final sneak in. I'm not a kid. This is a
playground. Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
Oh my god.
We're
really good at backtalking.
I can't protect you in there.
Flowers on your bike? I'm not worried. A girl like me?
A girl like you, with pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan.
Okay, look, we did it, I guess.
My boss decides who gets it, all right.
Boss is stuck. Who's your boss? Look the other way.
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
Oh my god.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
This crazy interaction, Chloe, honestly.
You really think you can take me?
It really makes sense.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't
care. What are you gonna do about
that, Chloe?
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
Lies.
I give up. You're alright, kid. Go on.
She's insane. Oh my god. I love her, though, but still, like, she's being so dangerous. Come on, that dude just let her in. Like, what? Like, it actually is pretty dangerous. Like, what the hell? It's been fun so far. I love this game so far. My god. I'm nervous for Chloe,
this
though.
This is intense.
Oh, shit. Oh, okay.
Amelia, come.
Oh my god, it's a cute dog. Oh, Jinx. Oh my god, can we pet the dog, please? question everything. Why? This is a really interesting looking place that we should not be at, by the way.
Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
She looks kind of nervous. Look at her hands. Okay. Oh my god. It sounds really cool though, just from here. Woo! I like it.
Can we look at the little dog? That dog's fierce.
Can I pet it? I don't. Okay.
What's her name?
I like dogs in this game.
Delia.
Oh, that's a cute name. So cute. I love animals.
She doesn't usually like people.
Well, neither does she.
Yeah. Me neither.
Oh, I knew it. Oh, little cute puppy. Okay, I'll leave you alone. I'm sorry. I won't cry. Okay. Drunk girl.
Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
That's terrible. Oh god, is something happening right now? Look at the tagging.
Damon Merrick again? Who is this guy?
Whoa, okay. Portmas.
Exactly as I'm explaining to you. All right.
That shirt is rad.
It's rad.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly.
Can we take it? Oh.
$20, baby.
Baby.
$20?
Ew.
That's robbery.
Hell?
And don't call me baby.
Yeah.
Fine. $20, thief.
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative.
Oh god, how are we gonna get creative?
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I'm explaining.
That guy's a dick.
All right, it's
I'd
not
love
gonna take
to
any
see
more
his
than
car
an hour to do it.
Right out from under him.
Oh no.
I can't hear you. Can you talk louder, please?
You're
if
in
you don't
a
have
show.
$20, beat it.
$20 is not that much.
No.
But for a shirt, that's a lot. What the hell?
Exactly
what about, like, can we gamble
right, it's
it? Like, $10?
Okay.
Does she not have money? Probably not.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday.
Why do you need this knife? Oh my god. Who are you?
Sketch Central.
Very sketchy looking. Beer.
Cold beer. Free for the taking.
Are we really gonna get random beer? I guess. Let's get some beer in our system, even though we should not do that shit. That's really bad for you, Chloe.
Drink more, feel less. Yes, please.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay. Hi, bartender. Wow, it's loud. Drunk guy?
That's totally me in 5 beers.
Oh my god.
Okay, 3.
No, you can't have that many.
300 dock workers laid off, their pensions canceled? God, Prescott's a real tool.
Wow, what the hell? We know who the Prescott's are though, so.
Graffiti everywhere. I think they missed a spot.
They did. Let's make that spot good. Evil eye or definitely evil eye. I like evil eyes.
What are you looking at?
Oh, that's cool looking. Actually. Oh yeah, and I'm pretty sure it's literally a different voice actress that's playing Chloe right now too. Oh, we got it right there. Lost unicorn. Oh my god, okay. There's a lot of stuff you can graffiti in this episode. Wait, look at this.
Damn, there are a lot of people here.
There is. I kind of want to get a shirt somehow. Chill, girl.
How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
Oh, dartboard? Can I play darts?
Reminds me of the way I make important life choices.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
No, thanks.
Oh, no.
I try to avoid hepatitis when I can.
Don't do that, Chloe. It's not a good idea. What the fuck?
Classy.
Wow. That's not YouTube friendly, everyone. I'm so sorry. Okay. Oh, Frank? Hi, Frank.
Frank Bowers? What is he doing here?
Yo, Frank!
Hey.
Oh my god. Oh, is he high at the home?
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing
here?
That's
so rude. What the hell?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
This feels really less cringy, honestly.
The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Oh my god. How about some weed? Do you come here a lot?
So, you come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Why are we, like, a drug and a alcohol
right.
addict? What the hell are we doing?
It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
I mean, it makes sense for the Life is Strange one, but still.
Okay,
what's
so,
weed?
You holding?
Weed?
I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe
oh
me.
Oh my god.
Shit. Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye.
Girl.
How about you spot me some? You know I'm good for it.
No way. I learned my lesson last time. Money first.
Really? We don't have any
Never
money,
mind,
though.
Then.
Suit yourself.
Well, let's go over to this guy and see what we can do.
This place is
we can't go
okay,
over here.
Good.
It'll be like... Should right, we talk about... Oh, yeah, yeah, right there. They gotta do that.
Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down
yeah,
any
okay.
minute.
Let's sit down the car real quick. Just a little. Release!
Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Yeah, don't overcharge.
Shit. No! Come
oh,
on!
That totally was not us.
Thanks for playing.
Get those shirts?
Dick.
Let's take that beautiful shirt.
Oh, yeah. Sweet, sweet victory.
Sweet victory for us.
That's like... 200 bucks.
Oh god. Still the money? Leave it? What kind of decision are we doing right now? There's not even like a blinking thing even. Oh my god. Do I steal it or do I leave it? I don't really know. We owe Frank, but like this is some random guy we don't know. What if it's like some bad guy or something? I guess let's steal it. YOLO, honestly. I'm scared about a little bit, okay? Actually have consequences. Oh no. I've seen that guy before. That was that guy
Holy
was at the
shit.
Diner a lot when we were playing.
I'm rich.
Oh no, Chloe. What did we just do? I'm scared.
Nothing sadder than a neglected bong.
Jesus. Oh no. We just stole money. I don't think that was a very good idea. Well, we can get our weed now, I guess. Even though I don't really want that.
She returns.
Chloe does so.
About that weed.
Here it comes.
No, we have money now, I guess.
Toss in a dime bag and we'll call it square.
Hey, what are you waving around with this kind of money here for?
Oh, God.
You really don't think before you act, do you?
Nope. So, where's my pot?
She just gave it all back to him? Oh,
no
my God.
No more loans. I'm not your fucking piggy bank.
You're a good man, Frank.
Eventually, now he stole the money.
No.
Oh, no.
I'm not.
You really
I'll
aren't.
Beat it,
Price. Why are you selling
You're cramping
weed
my
to children?
Style.
We're a child, literally. We're like 16.
I'll see you later.
Like, what the hell?
Whatever.
Why are we doing this? This isn't good, obviously, but I guess, like, we're emo and hardcore, so... All right. Let's go through here now.
Damn, there are a lot of people here.
Yeah, can we go over here?
Here we go.
I'm nervous. Oh god.
Fuck.
Oh, it's a sketchy guy. Oh no.
Hey. You okay?
I'm fine.
No.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Blow him off.
Fuck off, man.
Leave us alone.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No, and I don't care.
And I give zero shits.
Oh my God.
Let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
You're a bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go.
What the
Fine.
Hell? Oh, we're taking the stairs.
Maybe I can get a better view of the action from
New
up above.
New dialogue unlocked. Can we talk to him again or something?
If I want to see the band, I'll have to find another way. Those guys are trouble.
Oh God, be careful. Oh, can we talk to Frank about that, maybe? That makes sense if we do.
She returns.
Hi. Oh, yeah, right there.
Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
Who even is that?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Why are you so sketchy about it? What the hell?
Where do those stairs go?
Up?
Real helpful, Frank.
No shit, Frank.
I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine.
We'll go up
I'll
there.
See you later.
God.
Whatever.
Okay. Well, let's get up the stairs. Rotted stairs, I guess. I don't know. Gotta be careful. So excited.
Finally made it. I can't believe it.
Oh my God. Woo! We did it. She's having a really good time. This is cool though. I can't even hear me. But yeah. Oh my God. At least she's happy right here, right? Like, we were talking about her rotten corpse of a dad or something. Woo! Let's grab her. Sorry, YouTube. I know I'm copywriting. Oh! We just got up.
You spilled my beer, bitch.
What the hell? I'm gonna have fun.
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
Oh no.
Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer.
Oh my God.
She's calling us out, dude.
But
she's gonna
bitch.
Regret every word.
Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be
good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there.
Oh no.
And it won't be pretty.
We need help.
It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Ah. Oh God.
Damn.
It's Rachel. Oh my God. It's Rachel Amber. Oh, here's our little blinking thing. Choose carefully, that's what I have consequences. Let's attack them. Let's do it.
Ah!
Oh my. Oh, we just got punched. Oh God.
Rachel?
It is Rachel. Oh my God. She looks
Come
crazy
on.
Right here. Oh my God.
Hurry up.
Wow, did we just get saved? We made save ourselves pretty much, but... Wow!
Let me go,
Frank's gonna help us! Okay.
Not gonna happen! Calm down! Come on, man! Walk away!
Yeah,
Squeeze.
Why attacking us over your skull and spilled beer? Like, what are you doing?
Bullshit! Get the fuck out of here!
Are we with Rachel now? Oh my God! we beat Rachel Amber. That's crazy. Okay. Now we know why I love her so much. A drawing right there that we had in the journal. Wow, Rachel saved her. Oh my god. And we got punched. Oh wow. I'm loving the music in this game so far. It just my, like, you know. I'm not like this anymore, not emo, but whatever word you want to use. It's so nice sounding. Oh my god. It's all copyrighted. So, that's awkward. I don't know, is Chloe okay after getting punched? Oh my god. Oh, she's bruised. Oh my god. I don't know her to be in that fucking stupid situation anyway. God damn it. She looks really sad too. Life is Strange before the storm? Episode 1, Awake. Oh my god. She's just smoking weed. Okay. Love our copyrighted music, but it's so beautiful, I don't want to turn it off. Okay, let's get up. No more weed for you, Chloe. Wow, that was an intense night. But I guess it's the first time we meet Rachel Amber, so that's cool.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell.
Yeah. Why wouldn't you? Oh, Dad's gone! There's that thing right there. Oh my god. We can look at our journal?
Daily rituals are important. Even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Yeah. I feel so bad. Alright, this is our next page. Hey. Oh, I wonder why the background music's not playing anymore for this. The loser. Yeah, that's right. I called you a loser. Want to know why? Because you weren't at Firewalk last night. Even Frank was there. He's my dealer. Or, Mom, if you're reading this, he's my dealer that you shouldn't be reading this. It was maybe the greatest night of my life. I hiked just to this old mill using the train tracks, then verbally abused the dumb bouncer until he let me inside. Firewalk is the shit. Who knew ragers like that went down in little old Arcadia Bay. Fuck Seattle. Plus I have a sweet ass black eye for a souvenir. What? NBD. And there were these two assholes, skeepy guys. Whose manhood I wrecked. God. Oh yeah, and I got rescued by the most popular girl in school. How was your night, loser? Firewalk plus Chloe. And then the whatever sign that is, Max. Sorry, I'm not the smartest. Oh, we got Frank now. Oh my god. Frank. Old Mel. What the hell? Date of birth is old. Okay. We're a drug dealer, but Frank Bowers is actually pretty chill. He likes to act like he's a tough guy. And I have no doubt that he's done a lot of messed up things over the years. But to me, he seems like a scruffy dog. The tougher he tries to come off, the cuter he seems. What? What? I've been buying weed for Frank too close to a year. I almost never have enough money to pay him. And he always tells me that this is the last fucking time, Chloe, and I'm not your fucking friend. Then he always gives it to me anyway. Like I said, the guy's adorable. What the hell? Of course, if I ever did anything to actually get on Frank's bad side, he might not seem so cuddly anymore. I hear Frank rolls with some dudes who are into the way darker shit than keeping high schoolers medicated. It's hard to imagine Frank getting mixed up with anything really bad, but I guess you never know. For now, I'll just keep hoping that Frank is even worse at remembering who owes him money than he is at being intimidating. Chloe, that's not... no. Oh, I like all the colors in this one, though. Look how pretty it is. Wow. I guess, like, for the, like, getting high thing or something. And Frank has a dog, right? Yeah, he does. Maybe we'll see the, his dog. I forgot the dog's name, but maybe we'll see it as a puppy this time. I'm excited for that if we do. We have more graffiti. Okay. Let's keep looking at stuff.
Hey, Max. Hey, Dad.
Aww.
Another day in paradise.
God. Right?
Chloe, wakey, wakey,
Eggs and Bakey. Oh, wakey, wakey, Eggs and Bakey.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl.
The most popular girl in school, apparently.
Was that really Rachel Amber?
Yeah, it was. Oh my god.
You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Her room looks so different from the In Life is Strange. Like, she didn't have the pirate stuff right there. I mean, I guess it's only like a year or two later. From when her dad died. But like, wow, it's so close to being so emo.
Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors.
Oh.
To do with all the health and safety violations they've suffered this year.
She's listening to her radio, too.
I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually.
Look at her joints.
Wake and bake is part of a healthy breakfast.
Let's go get actual breakfast, because that's what I want. Oh, what are we doing? What, we're tagging more things? Oh my god.
Better living through chemistry.
420, oh my god, girl. Well, we have a lot of stuff in
that
our room.
That really was Rachel Amber.
Oh yeah.
And she saved my life. How was last night even real?
Is that Warren right there? I think that's Warren. I don't like Warren. Brooke, right? Maybe not. I think I recognize some of the... Oh yeah, Alyssa right there. Oh my god. Yeah, those are all the people that Max went to school with.
Ask Miss Arcadia.
Oh, Chloe Price.
You're the only source of info I trust in this town.
I can't read that. So how do I... Okay. Dear Miss Arcadia, did you hear about Firewalk coming to town? I checked all the local venues, but nobody knows anything. Not at all the local venues, apparently. Don't know about the bumping the thread thing. Okay, gents, here's a scoop. It's a private party, not as in. You're not invited, more like you're better off staying away. And I know I just made some of you more into it than ever, so proceed at your own risk. Abandon all hope, all ye who enter. Ever heard of the mill, Miss Arcadia? Thanks, Scrooge. Oh shit, if you go, don't look anybody in the eyes. If you look anybody in the eyes, don't look away. If you look away, you should. Why would you start listening to my advice now? Oh, look at my eyes. My eyes are alien. Great movie. What are you talking about? Not of the earth, only the original though. What's the mill? That's adorable. Previous topic. Interesting. I don't know what it's
Wait,
spread. Sorry.
What? Who? What photo?
What? Oh god. Chloe Price, Victoria Chase commented on a photo you're tagged in?
I have feelings about this.
Oh my
god. Most of them are not good feelings.
She posted a picture of us with her? The artwork is so different from Life is Strange 1 too. Oh my god. You look crazy. Firewalk, jealous. You look hot. Who's the arm candy? Deborah something. Deborah Borgen, I think. Oh my god. They don't even know her name. So fun. Kisses. Get it, girl. Who's Deborah Borgen with Rachel in the picture? Great. You're so gorgeous. I hate you. XOXO. And who's the arm? And dude, that's Chloe Price. Taylor, wasn't Rachel invited to your sleepover last night? I was wondering where she was. Burn. Oh no. I didn't mean to make it like that. So much fun. This is really intelligent. This is a really intelligent conversation, says Alyssa. Wow, okay. So we're like officially tagged into our
thing. One of these days I'm actually going to use you to do my homework.
No, we're not. Wow, okay. Photo.
Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair.
Oh my god. She definitely put away a lot of these things.
Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear.
Oh, that's cute. Tear it down?
Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid, but then all the unicorns died.
We're not tearing that down. What are you on?
Fun fact.
I love sharks.
Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child.
Girl, no. We're not talking about sharks like that. Sharks are friends. We love sharks in this household.
Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
Oh my god, that's funny. Pirate power. Oh my god, we've seen that before too. When we're looking into our room in the first game.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firelock last night.
I said all these, you have to delete that photo of me dancing, haha, only you could get me to loosen up like that. Happy 2 month anniversary, Elliot. So is Elliot just our friend? I'm pretty sure Elliot is just our friend. I feel like we hang out with him a lot and stuff. Okay.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome.
Oh my god. You're crazy.
I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
Skateboard, that's crazy.
Nice one,
Chloe. Oh god, their eyes.
Mom's gonna love the new look.
Totally. I love all the music that's playing though, it's cool.
I bet Long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago.
Probably, yeah. Okay, I think we looked at every single thing in her beautiful room. I'm not tearing down the unicorn picture because it's cute. Oh, her report? We didn't look at a report card.
Man, I am killing it this year.
Oh.
Somehow I don't think Mom's going to feel the same way.
It's not that bad, a C, D, C, D, C. What the hell? Why is it so, in order? It could be worse. Let's put it in the trash can now.
Yeah, no one needs to see that. Thank you.
It's not that bad, though. Okay, I think we can go now, I'm pretty sure.
How do I want to express my teenage angst today?
Oh god, did we get to pick our outfit? Because I love doing that. Oh, look at the butterfly one! That is perfect, if you know, you know. Oh, here's our firewalk that we stole, and the raven, right? Yeah. Oh my god. Okay, so what can I choose? Right, do I have to choose right now? Or let me see. Or can I, like, look at all of them? I kind of want to look at all of them, not gonna lie. Oh, that's so cute! Look at her! I love that shirt. Oh. Do we choose this? Let's look at all of them. I like that shirt though, so I might choose that one. What's bonus outfit? Oh, hot dog man. Punk dough. What's punk dough mean? Oh, wow. That's definitely not her style, no. I mean, it kind of is. This part of it is. But not the shirt, not really. That's like more Max style, the does. What does the raven look like? The raven looks so cool. I'm just like a dresser person. I like dressing things. That's a little bit too bright for my eyes. But it's really cute though. I think it's like the bird that's in the corner of everything, I'm pretty sure. Look at our firewalk. help it. How cool does that look? Oh, wow. It's the same shirt that weird guy was wearing, though. It's cool, but I don't think it was worth stealing. No offense. But, like, she likes it, so it's great for her. Classic Chloe.
Firewalk. Heard it through the grapevine. They had an impromptu concert on the edge of town last night.
Is what she wears in the Life is Strange 1, maybe?
Give me a call.
Oh,
night.
Yeah. This is literally Chloe right here. This is what she always wore. I don't know what to choose now. Oh my god, I love the butterfly one, though. Now I'm having a hard time choosing. Classic Chloe really is her, though. Like, that's her in a nutshell. Let me look at these ones real quick again. Maybe Illuminati? What does that look like? I'm up against the classic Chloe and the butterfly so far, so... Oh, this was also classic Chloe, pretty much. Yeah. I don't know what to choose! Oh my god, this is really what I'm, like, debating right now in this game, and there's probably way more things. Let's look at, Hot Dog Man. Is it the cartoon thing? Pretty sure it is. Yeah, that's so weird. That's not our classic Chloe. I like the butterfly. I'm not gonna choose the butterfly. Even though I like the beanie and the boots and the outfit. I don't know about that one. I'm gonna choose this one, honestly. I'm gonna stop debating and being indecisive. I like the butterfly one in the beginning, so I will choose that one. Maybe. Yeah, it's really cute. Like, look at it. Does it matter? Like, what I wear? I don't know, but I'm gonna choose this one. Yeah. I like this one.
Can't leave without my vitamins.
Oh, what vitamins? Oh, her drugs. All right, let's get going.
I really should get going.
We can go again and get dressed again. That's so crazy. I'm tempted to go back to her classic Chloe look, honestly. The lines on the shirt is kind of bothering my little tiny brain. I might, honestly. Sorry, guys. The lines are just really hurting my brain. So, yeah. I'm gonna do classic Chloe. I like that one the most anyway. This was a really cute shirt. If there wasn't a whole bunch of lines on it, it like really hurts my little brain. This is really cute though. I like this one. This is what her normally would wear. So let's choose this one. And the beanie is so cute too. Alright, let's go. Classic Chloe.
I really should get going.
We looked at everything, right? Even the shark. Yeah, we looked at every single thing in here. The room never looks really different, but not as different. Clearly she moves some stuff, but it's a skateboard. There's no Marissa or Sharky. Okay, let's go.
Shit, whew. Where's my phone? God,
oh, no.
It's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
She doesn't have her
Guess
phone
I better try calling my phone. With moms.
Oh my god, it's not that big of a deal, Chloe. How long did I spend trying to choose her outfit? My god.
Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Where did we leave it? Medicine cabinet.
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend.
Oh my god, obviously.
Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
No, you shouldn't. You should dye it blue.
The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, Scourge of Arcadia Bay.
Arcadia Bay. Okay. Oh, look outside. My god, okay. Ring.
Mom's old engagement ring.
Aww.
Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
Is she really gonna sell it? Oh my god. And that's not audio, sorry. That's something we could talk about with her, probably.
Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup.
Oh. Girl. Oh, wait. I want this. Look at this first.
I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old.
Oh.
If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed.
It's not that embarrassing. It's cute that she kept that. I'm pretty sure Max literally looked at that, too. Oh, my God. She kept that even after all those years.
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Place on dresser. I feel so bad doing this, but like, it's what Chloe would do.
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
Yeah. I'm gonna cry. What is up with the music right now? Does that definitely change something? You always, like, forget how serious this fucking game is, even after all the sarcastic stuff and jokes and stuff like that. It's a pretty serious thing.
Oh, okay. Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
Oh my Jesus Christ. Okay. We didn't need to see that, especially as Chloe. Read.
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech.
Oh god, okay.
Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie.
Oh,
better.
Wow. How is that better? What the hell? Damn. Oh, it's 7 a.m. Exactly.
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Oh, she's allowed to look at stuff she wants, so...
Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign.
Oh. Okay, let's call her fucking phone before I start crying.
Why would I open that drawer again?
I don't know. I didn't mean to. Can we just keep opening the fucking drawer? Oh my god, we can, wait.
Why would I open that drawer again?
Oh my god, that's so funny. Okay, let's stop opening the fucking drawer. Good god, okay. Let's call our phone.
How can Mom look at this every day
oh
and not
god.
See what a tool she's dating?
She's in love, apparently. Oh, she's still wearing that necklace with the bullet things or whatever. That's cute. Oh! She looks so different with that blue hair. I can't get over it. Okay, let's go find her.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
Not in there. It's in the bathroom, right? Yeah. Right there! Underneath there.
Ugh. I drank way too much last night. Or was it just enough?
Too much. She should not be drinking at all.
There we go.
There's our phone.
Wonder how many calls I've missed.
How many did she miss? Oh god, I'm scared. Oh! Two new messages! Oh, our mom is so worried about us! Will it call away be home by curfew? There will be consequences. Elliot, dude, that's the third time. I already know everything. Nothing in the journal. Yeah, she definitely does not write in the journal nearly as much as Max.
Bring my purse down with you, please.
Max wrote like 700 pages every second.
Okay,
let's get her purse.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Yeah, I think it was in her room, I'm pretty sure. There's her ring. Bed. drawer. Wait, I don't see your purse. Oh, right there, wait. We looked at our purse, I remember now. Let's get our mother's purse.
Can you grab my cell phone too?
Oh my god,
no,
why?
I need to talk to you.
What are you going to talk to us about?
That really makes me want to hurry.
Let's not hurry then.
Coming, Mom.
Oh my god, that was an awkward scene. Coming, Mom. And it just like ends off right there.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table.
But
you might still
have
time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Oh, we had to look at everything though, even though we've already looked at every single thing. With Max. That's probably way different. Ears.
David's
early.
Here
oh.
So early.
There's David.
Mom calls him just a friend, but look at him. He's pretending he didn't just spend the night.
And you never saw the condoms, Chloe.
You never
saw
the condoms.
You saw it 3 times, Chloe, but okay. Okay.
Dad
Chloe's
took
so
these
funny.
Photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
God. Nothing on the phone. Oh wow, we can go through the trash.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Well, it might be hard for him to keep working after everything he's went through. We have a lot to talk about our mom with, apparently.
Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
Oh no. We can open them? Oh no.
Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case.
God damn it. Really, Julie, don't need that at all. Oh look, it's her.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
No, she has that inside of her drawer.
And never looked back?
I'm so sorry. Oh, what happened to the
family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one.
Oh.
Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room.
Oh my god, I remember those TVs though, literally. Okay.
Hard to believe I was an 8th grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school?
Oh god. Plants.
It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault, really.
We're already supporting one. Thanks.
From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me.
Oh my god. Probably.
Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist.
Wait, those aren't Mom's keys.
Are those David's
and
keys?
And these would be David's keys.
There's
probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe?
Probably. Oh no. He's probably gonna move in, Chloe, and we're gonna have to deal with it together. Can we go outside? Maybe we can. Wow, she says a lot of sarcastic things when you're playing this here. It's crazy. Oh my god, we can look at this and shake
Feeling
it.
Trapped?
It's a doe!
Right there with you.
That's Max's thing. Oh, the little reference. I'm really loving Chloe in this, before the storm. She's obviously way
like,
more hurt,
What the
too.
Hell just happened?
What the hell just happened? But yeah, she's a lot more like, you know, emo
Shoot.
And depressed and stuff like that.
I was hoping David could get a job on a container ship.
Oh,
to
God.
Japan.
What?
Why God. Do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
No. No fireworks allowed. Fines doubled for illegal fireworks and campfire.
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt.
Oh my god.
Thank you.
Chloe.
Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Oh my god. Jesus. Girl, you're crazy. Put the purse on the table. You can look in here though, right?
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
My god.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast.
Is that for David? Probably. Got some dishes to be done. There's eggs.
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
I guess so. But is this a cool thing, like, just seeing her cook like that? Like, that was good, actually, not gonna lie. Okay, we got our pot roast. Can we talk to her before I put her purse down?
Joyce Price, a.k.a. Mom. She looks as beat as I feel.
God.
Go put my purse on the table before you forget.
Oh, I won't forget. Don't worry. Don't worry, Mom. All right, time to put her purse.
Chloe, I don't have all day.
She just dropped it on there.
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Oh, God, no. Let's not let her die. Time to speak to our
mother.
Hey,
Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal.
Oh, yeah, we got bruised.
I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately.
How many times were you bruised?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry, I'll do better. I was sleeping. I'll do better.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Yeah. You're a
mom. Is that what you wanted to talk about?
Love you.
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Oh no, a lot of things that we have to talk to her about. Pot roast, engagement ring, him, school. What about the engagement ring?
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Oh god.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then?
Exactly, like, you told us to get the fucking purse.
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes?
We're not very happy right now.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
Oh
my
god.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah. An old-fashioned dickhole.
Jesus. Girl.
Ah,
we're not happy.
School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah.
Chloe, not
anymore. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
She's not really joking, but...
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something
later.
But
no, eat!
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made four eggs, two for David, two for me. And just before I served them, he says, what are you gonna eat?
Well, two eggs is not
I'll
that
enjoy
much,
that,
but
huh?
There's two of them.
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that-
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip?
Oh
do
my
you
God.
Think I enjoy lying for you?
I hate
saying
the
arguing.
You're
sick just so you don't get expelled. And I do know what pot smells like, you know.
Ugh. We're getting
Between
in trouble.
Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me.
Oh my god,
Never
Chloe,
again.
Stop!
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David could help. Maybe I could just need to be left alone. I don't know which one. I don't like arguing with our mom. She's trying her best, and so are we. It's like, it's really awkward. I don't know what to say. I guess I need to be left alone.
Maybe I just need to be left alone.
Maybe you're 16 and don't know what you need. David thinks you need discipline.
Oh, God.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
I wish I said that then. Dad was a good man. David's an... Oh, God. Saying Dad was a good man is so bad. Because she probably misses him, too. It's like...
Your boyfriend's an asshole.
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs you the wrong way because you've been rude.
Oh God, she's
He's
just...
still breathing. That means
oh
I've
God.
Been more than fair.
Girl, don't do that.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Oh no.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying.
She is trying.
I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Be understanding, say what you feel. Oh no. It's like, she honestly, in all honesty, she should be understanding, but also it's good to say what you feel. But then again, she's like, you're only 16, you don't know what you want, but like, she knows what she feels, so. I don't know. Say what you feel, be understanding, oh god. This game is literally just like going through all of Chloe's, like, all the emotions, everything she's going through, her emo phase of, yeah, and then like years after her dad dies, and like dealing with getting a new dad figure thing or whatever. Too relatable. Okay, I don't know. I don't want to be mean to Joyce. She's a really nice mother. Be understanding. Say what I feel. I'm sorry.
You want me to pretend I'm okay with David? That everything's okay?
Oh God,
I'm not.
So sorry.
He's a chauvinistic piece of shit, frankly.
Oh no.
If your father could hear you.
What?
No, you're right. I'm sure Dad and the mustache would get along great. It's a big bed. There's room enough for all three of you.
Oh,
that's enough.
Mike, wait, we should have said
a
weird
thing. All I'm asking for is a little respect. Why is that too much?
Jesus.
I love you, Chloe.
That was a lot.
I miss you.
I should have
Nobody could have replaced your father. I did the best I could.
Mom.
We know that.
I don't know where I lost you.
You didn't lose us.
You didn't lose me.
Right. David's waiting. He'll need the keys. They're in that ashtray you made me. Go be his problem now.
Ugh. Bringing David his keys is about
Go
the most humiliating
problem.
Thing Mom could ask me to do.
I'm gonna cry. That was so mean. Both of us. I'm not good with conflict. That was very conflict. Okay, let's take his fucking keys then. Jesus Christ. Okay. I should have known Chloe would have been, like, really not...
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David.
Can we
it
run, please?
It better get going.
Oh, we got a message. From whom? Maybe I shouldn't do that right when I'm... Wait, let's let her walk out the door first. Oh, wow, we're outside. There's the raven, right? That's the bird, the raven bird.
What a piece of crap.
It's following us, just like
the car,
doe did
too.
In Life is Strange. And the butterfly.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
What the hell?
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
Good God. What are you telling
no,
us
Mom,
to do?
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
And she smiled when saying that to herself in her mind. Like,
Chloe,
what the hell are you talking
is
about,
that
girl?
A black eye?
No.
Insubordination.
Where even is it right now?
No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Oh, God.
Tell
okay.
me again what I
Step
owe my
douche.
Mother, dirtbag.
electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Sorry, I said that way before anyone really
yes.
know what it is.
It
but
ignites
did you not
part...
hear me? I
oh.
said I know what it does.
We do
then
know what it
grab
does.
Grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
Okay. But yeah, I already know like what she calls
this?
Him in Life
Quality
is
Quality time?
Not yet, though, really.
Better it's just like, get the socket wrench and get this over with.
It's like him barely coming into our life, literally. This is like him just being here, I guess. Why would he pick up that?
Wait, isn't that a socket wrench right there?
Is it? I don't know, girl. Let's go look around first. Wait, I think we have a message, by the way, actually. Oh, we have more of a journal. Okay, want to read our journal, everyone? Yeah, Max definitely wrote in her journal way more than Chloe, but it makes sense. Alright, 5-7-2010. Max, do you know how things with Mom seemed like they couldn't get any worse, huh? The sad truth is, I suddenly have to choose between being nice or being honest with her, because I can't be both. But how can I be honest with her about Mustache without her lashing out at me for it? And why am I the only one concerned about this hostile takeover of her house? Today, it's a toolbox and pot roast. Tomorrow, it's... I should stop there for sanity's sake. And yeah, I know Mom is stressed about money issues and still doesn't justify her horrible taste in men. Also, Mom knows I've been skipping, which sucks, but in a way makes me feel better about it. Does that make me a bad person? That I don't feel bad about fucking off, just relieved that I don't have to waste my energy to lie about it anymore? On second thought, don't answer that. Chloe, the no good, very bad person. She's not that bad of a person, honestly, though. She just had a hard, like, life as a child. It's like... God. Okay, who's Steph? Hey, is this Chloe? This is Steph Gingrich? Hey. Her response, oh my god. I have your dud. You can get it before school. Thanks. Oh. You can tell she's not happy, even in her messages back to people. Oh, here's the garage. We've been here a lot. It's cool seeing everything before.
What's David doing? Leaving stuff in our garage anyway?
Oh god.
Does he think he's moving in or something?
Sorry to tell you, Chloe, but I think he is. Thinks he is gonna do that. Okay.
Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire.
Excuse me? Chloe? Oh my god.
The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop.
She's so violent.
I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first.
Oh yeah. I'm pretty sure she literally has that stereo in her room. Oh my god. She does take that. It's cool.
Dad's old camera.
Oh.
Do they even make film for these anymore?
Doesn't she give that to Max? Oh my god, I think she does.
Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again.
Oh no.
This was the photo Mom took down from the living room.
Oh yeah.
Guess we don't
is.
Have room for it and David's mustache.
God. That's a cute picture. That's really sad.
David's lawnmower.
God.
Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that?
Clearly not. Okay, here's a toolbox.
Dad's toolbox.
Oh, it's her dad.
He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted.
Home. Okay.
Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff?
God.
Asking for a friend.
Probably not, Chloe.
By toolbox, did David mean this, or did he mean himself?
I guess this. Okay. Alright, where is it? Is it in there? Oh, it is. Maybe?
50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40.
What?
Maybe 90-10.
Girl, what are you on right now? What are you talking about? Oh my god. She's making so many violent threats. It's actually crazy.
Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.
Oh my god! Okay. Did I miss something? I hope not. She's not even running. What the hell? Wait, we looked at the camera. That's usually outside, right? I'm pretty sure it is. Maybe it's not. Alright. Can we pick up that still? No. Alright. So can we speak to him?
So?
You find the socket wrench set yet?
Calm down.
You can do that one simple thing, can't you?
We have already.
He's Mom should date literally anyone else.
Alright, let's give him
a little more hustle
thing.
Wouldn't have killed you.
We're looking at everything. What's wrong with that? He is being kind of mean to us, so I don't really understand that part. How are we supposed to be nice to someone that's being mean to us? Like, what?
See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign
carbon
of carbon
deposits.
Oh,
no,
she knows
shit.
Her stuff. Okay.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
I guess it does. Like, she's funny. Fist bump. Leave him hanging, except a bump. Does he deserve a fist bump? He's been kind of mean to us. Like, okay, I guess so. We're being
fine.
Nice to him, I guess.
Whatever.
Whoa, fist bump. I wonder, I mean, he probably knows that her dad died.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
What? There's a toolbox right there.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Oh, maybe he doesn't know that dad's dead, because why would he laugh at her dead dad's toolbox? What the hell? That is so effed up. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you, dude?
Ready to roll?
Please don't
want
to talk.
No.
Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Oh, no.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure.
Oh my
so
god.
So there are some things I want to be real clear about.
Excuse me? Vacation from having a father figure? Do you think it was a vacation from our dad dying? What? I am not happy right now with what this dude is talking about. Fuck you.
Respect
are you fucking
him?
Joking me?
I think it's time I show this asshole
that
I'm not interested
shit.
In
he
anything
just said
he
to
has
her?
To say. What's clear is fuck you.
Literally,
language.
Like, what kind of vacation
you way
shit?
Way out of line, young lady.
Oh, language?
No. Language? Military language?
Here, let me put that in a language you'll understand.
Oh god, no.
Foxtrot. Uniform.
You've got a smart mouth, don't you?
Can't threaten me, you're stupid. Let me dumb it down.
Let me dumb it down for you. I mean, sorry. What has fewer syllables than dumb?
Oh, God.
Hey, watch your... I can crap.
What kind of insult is that?
Then I hope you're a better plumber than you are a mechanic.
You... Your mother...
No, I'm not. You. What the hell did you just say to me, bro? Like, are you fucking joking?
At least she has a heart. All you have is... What's it called when you've got one porn
oh,
stash
shit.
And zero game?
I was in the army.
Oh
you
god.
You will respect me.
Bro, I respect you, but not the shit you said to me.
I don't remember enlisting, so don't treat me like your newest recruit.
Yeah. Jesus
if
Christ.
You were a man,
it's
I'd...
cool. If you were a man, I wouldn't go so easy on you either.
Oh my god. You kind of deserve that, not gonna
don't
lie.
Know why I bother trying.
How is that trying
mission
what you just said to her? I am lost right now, bro. Like, I feel bad for being that mean, but, like, he did not need to say that. Like, are you joking? And I'm not unreasonable right now. Like, what the hell? Like, why would you say that to someone that lost their father? It's not a vacation. Oh my god.
Country?
I'm defending her so much right
you're
now.
Sick?
I'm defending her so much, and I cannot let her be through anything bad.
Dad loved this song.
A that's the dream she's talking about? Like the realistic dreams? I think it is.
I just called to tell you that I miss you.
Oh no, I'm scared. I got also the country music. These dreams actually really like is right there in the
what
front
a beautiful
driving.
Day.
Oh my god, there he is.
This isn't right.
Oh no, I didn't even see that. What the hell?
I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
God. Chloe.
If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that truck off.
Oh no. I don't want to speak to him. He's not even here.
Turn it up.
Dream? Oh my god! I felt that. Holy fucking shit. I physically just jumped out of my skin. Oh my god. I did not need to see that. Oh my. Well then, that just happened. What a terrible fucking dream.
Hey.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Oh my god. She should really talk to her mom about those dreams. Like, I'm not gonna say thanks to him. What the hell? Okay, I guess so, but
shit.
Still.
Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone
We're
with
saying
me, young
thank
lady.
You.
I can see you rolling your eyes.
Oh my god.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
Okay, shut the fuck up.
I'll
leave us alone. Okay. What the hell is wrong with him? Like, we literally just said thanks. We didn't need to
Hello,
say that. I could have said
hell.
Whatever. Black hell. Here we are. We're so used to this place. Oh my god. But like, used to those missing posters everywhere. So there's not gonna be this time. Good luck, seniors. Is she supposed to be a senior? I don't really know. Oh, wow. I wonder if I missed anything for graffiti. Because there was one that said David shit on it, and I feel like I probably could have graffitied on it, and I missed it, probably. God damn it. I'm so sorry, guys.
Hey, Chloe.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh.
Hey, Elliot.
Oh, the guy just
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What?
No, we don't.
This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then.
Oh, God.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social okay. media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
It was
so,
pretty cool, actually.
How about the Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
I don't think it's
yeah,
Chloe's thing.
Totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
What? Aren't we just friends? Or are you asking as a friend? That sounds awful. I feel like she would not like that. What the hell?
No way. I'd rather have my eyes gouged out with rusted forks.
Yeah, right.
Me too.
Me too, I guess.
Jesus.
All right.
That was
See you in cam.
A mental
yeah,
image.
For sure.
I'd rather have my eyes gouged out with rusted forks. Wow, that's the most emo thing in the world.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class.
Oh, right there. Get DVD from Steph, okay. Let's look at everything.
Nathan in tights. Can't
oh,
unsee.
Oh, Nathan? Oh my god. Where's Nathan?
How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance?
Jesus Christ, Chloe.
Yeah. Well, at least not for now.
Sci-fi movie club. That's Warren's thing, right? Oh, Steph. Wait. I always forget where Tab is. Okay. Hey, I'm at the picnic tables with Mikey. Thanks. On my way. Oh, we got another thing. Oh, we haven't even met them yet, actually. Maybe we should wait a second to read that, because I don't know. We haven't seen them yet. We did meet this dude, so. He asked us, I don't know what he asked us, honestly. I said no, though, so. As far as Black Hole students go, Elliot Hampton is pretty not terrible. He hangs out with some of the douchers sometimes, but I get the sense that he's mostly alone with, like, this chick. Similar to my class schedule, Elliot and I have history, but no chemistry or drama. We hooked up a few times shortly after Dad died, but there wasn't much to it. I think I was just bored, maybe a little lonely. Weird, I know. Oh, wow, okay. I don't always get where Elliot's coming from. He's honestly asking to do stuff with me, which is nice, but I'm not sure we have that much in common anymore. Sometimes when we talk, it seems almost like he's studying me. I can tell if he totally wants to be friends or just get in my pants. I guess I should be flattered either way, but I'm not sure how much I care. Sorry, Elliot. See, I was right. And we have our pages. Is this the one? No, this one. No, she doesn't really write that much. 5/7/2010. So this mustache drove me to school today. Yep, yeah, this morning she calls him the mustache. Like, what the hell? Yep, that was totally my life's become. My what? That's what my life's became. Even worse, he thought the ride was like, tell me how things are gonna be from now on, opportunity. I shut that shit down real quick, but I have a feeling he's gonna run crying to my mom. But about it, because that's the kind of little man baby he is. Yeah, the things he said to us is not cool, like, that's why I did that. I wouldn't have done that if I didn't think that was bad, okay. Oh yeah, the dream. Had a dream about Dad again. The one where I was there when it happened. It seems to get harder and harder after each of these to remember what's real and what's not. All I can remember after I wake up is how much I miss him. I hope that never goes away. The glory wasn't there, or was I? Oh god, okay. And this is what I had to read, but we had to meet them first, so. Alright, let's talk to- Oh, is he the secure- Oh my god, he is the security guard before, is that douche? Sorry, I can't get that.
Skip Matthews, Blackwell's finest.
Right now
he's not so bad for a mall cop.
Mall cop? But yeah, I can't get, like, that's all I know who the guy is. That's all I know, step douche. But obviously he's the mustache now, so. Alright, let's talk to this guy.
Hey, Skip.
Hi, Skip.
Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today.
What the hell?
Oof, looks like you did, though.
Huh?
Oh my god.
Ah, right. Whatever.
Where even is the bruiser?
I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Wow!
Yeah, you know how I roll.
Good job. Firewalk show? What's firewalk show?
So, I went to the mill last night. Caught firewalk live.
You went to the mill? Wait.
Yeah, we did.
You saw a firewalk?
Are we like besties with the
cool
security guard? That's weird.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
Don't judge good music.
What? Like good music?
Preach it, sister. I'm in a band, actually.
No shit. Really?
He's in a band?
We're called Pisshead.
Pisshead?
It's not a big deal
oh
or anything.
Oh my god, what?
I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Can we listen
Pisshead,
to it?
Huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it?
Oh, yeah.
Our demo, I mean.
Maybe another time, sure. Why not?
Yeah, okay.
Great.
This is interesting. A little interaction with our security guard. Let's see what it sounds like. Pisshead. Oh, wow. It does sound nice, actually. It's kind of awkward just standing there listening to it like that, but. Oh! That actually sounds really good. Oh, did she like it? Wow. Hope you guys are enjoying this part one of my Life is Strange Before the Storm stuff. It's so fun so far. I might be ending it soon, but so far it's really awesome. Really sad, but I love Chloe. This is good, actually. Listen to the whole song. Wow! This would be cool if that is like we're made to score with Firewalk or whatever. I love how at first it sounded like it was for the phone and now it's in our ears. Like, that's really cool. That's cool, actually. I like it. Even like the the singing voice is good too. Guitar, oh my god, this sounds nice. How long is the song? Oh, we finished it, okay.
So, what did you think?
I love it, oh my god, meh?
That
oh,
was really
so mean.
Good, man.
No?
If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Yeah, me too,
oh,
actually.
Right on.
I literally
awesome,
would.
Chloe, thanks.
That was a cool experience to listen to. Wow! Good job, Chloe. I like that. Let's talk
morning,
to
Miss Grant.
Miss Grant, I know her.
Chloe, are you all right?
Oh.
Yeah, I'm fine.
We're okay.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today?
That sounds highly probable. I don't want to ruin the mystery.
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
Yeah. Wait and see, Miss Grant.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good. But instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
It's just the opposite, right?
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me.
What is this, art school?
Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad.
Yeah, but still, it's an art school. Your support soon too, things will turn around. Oh, I don't know which one to press.
Maybe in another 6 months, a new donor will come along with money for, I don't know, more lasers.
More lasers?
What the fuck?
Do we have any lasers?
Sadly, no.
Wow,
that
we
is
need
sad.
Lasers. My god, why is Chloe so funny? That is sad. Can we go over here?
No, Chloe.
Oh, no.
Class is back the other way.
No, I don't want to go to class. No, no, no. No, no, no. Okay, let's look at this. Can we
I prefer to wake and bake. But
oh,
hey,
God.
To each their own.
You missed your breakfast.
But fire's so pretty.
What the hell? Girl, don't support fire for it. Forest fires, it's so effed up.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
They know the drugs. Winning while doping isn't a winning at all. It's a quick trip to deep end of failure. What the fuck is that supposed to mean, honestly, though? Oh, graffiti! Okay, there we go. I knew looking around to be. We didn't get David's stuff. I don't think so. Maybe not. I don't know. Firewalk rocks? Principal Wells rocks? I don't know. What about Firewalk? What is this one?
Last night's show was too
epic. Oh, wow. That's actually really cool. Oh my god. Did we miss one? Lost Unicorn? Did we clearly miss something? The Cry? I should look up a video to see where all the graffiti is, because I don't want to miss them. I want to see all the things we could do. Oh my god. I didn't know that we were about to do this. Why are we smoking right now? What the hell are... Is that cigarettes? Oh my god, Chloe, I thought you were gonna smoke weed or something. Not cigarettes, what the hell?
Students at Blackwell have this herd instinct to glom up into little groups, like sheep.
Oh,
and if
yeah.
you just want to be alone, you get labeled like some dangerous outsider. Just like any other prison. Except now the prison follows you wherever you go, thanks to social media.
Oh, it's okay.
I can't believe Rachel posted a photo of the two of us together last night.
Yeah, I think she likes us. Maybe.
Am I still an outsider if I'm hanging out with Rachel Amber now? And what does it mean that hanging out was so awesome? Does that make me just the same as every other student here?
Oh,
nah.
My.
Fuck that.
We're not like other girls. Okay. She looks so cool. Interesting conversation with ourselves, honestly, but I think Rachel likes us, maybe. I'm sure of it. Oh, what is this? Oh, it's the play thing, right? Oh my god. The Tempest or whatever? Oh, why does it look so weird? What the hell? We can sit here too? Wow, we're really pondering existence right now.
I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care.
Oh god, we know.
Did last night really happen? The internet says it did, but I still can't believe it. Rachel Amber.
Rachel fucking Amber.
The drama star, honor student, popular princess of Blackwell swoops in like Batman to
like
save
Batman.
My ass and crash to Firewalk? Either that was a dream or real life just got a shit ton crazier.
Do not walk on the stage either. Huh. I mean, it really did happen, so clearly she was like, oh my god.
Principal Wells.
Hi, Principal
Hi.
Wells. We know you.
Stay cool, Chloe. You've got a marijuana-flavored bag of expulsion in your pocket.
Oh no, it's gonna take it away from
Chloe Price. Is that a black eye?
Yep.
I hope you know that Blackwell provides confidential counseling services for all our students.
Oh, God.
We are a safe space for any issue.
I'm good. It's the other guy who needed a safe space. From me.
You never fail to conform to your reputation, do you?
We really don't.
Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage.
Well,
such
we were
disregard
sitting
for
on
your
it.
Fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
I didn't do it, I swear. How about minor infractions? Oh god, I don't know.
I swear to you, I did not walk on that stage. It was more of a saunter.
Do I look amused?
No,
to you?
But I'm
I don't
amused.
Know. I've only seen you with one expression. That's the one.
Oh my
god. Perhaps you
god,
will find
girl.
Me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell
no
has a zero tolerance policy.
What? Oh, do you smell it?
And yet if my olfactory sense does not fail
oh, no.
me, I'd say you've recently been exposed to marijuana smoke.
No, we haven't.
Shit.
Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price?
No.
That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today.
Oh my god.
How does
why?
That sound?
Actually, no.
Wells really has it out for me. I have to convince him it's in his best interest to back off. Actually, sir, I'm gonna go with no.
We've been doing.
Ah. So you're going to mouth off to me now,
oh,
yes?
Oh no, we only have two
and
options.
And here I thought your well of
one.
Witticisms had finally run dry.
My well is deep?
Sir, my well of witticisms
We're
runs
doing
so
good
deep
this.
That you would get trapped at
I
the bottom and never make it out alive.
Jokes?
He's not like amused.
In my experience, that's how the guilty cover up their infractions.
Oh, the guilty now? Who's guilty
Sorry,
now?
Sorry, Wellesley, but you've fallen right into my trap. I've been recording this entire conversation for my blog about human rights abuses at Blackwell.
Oh my god!
You have a blog. Hold on. What abuses have you endured?
A lot.
You know, I've had to talk to you for like 2 minutes. That's a long time.
We are a private institution, and policy allows me to search all students on the premises.
What the hell? Prescott policy?
I wonder if the Prescotts might reconsider their donation if Blackwell's principal is being sued for harassment.
Oh my god.
How do you know about the Prescott donation?
Perhaps the better question you should be asking yourself is, what else do I know?
That's what you get from looking around everywhere, apparently.
I'm sure we, do not need to make so public an issue of your behavior today. But make no mistake, Miss Price.
Oh my god.
This is not over.
We know it's not over, but like, god.
Goody. I love cliffhangers. Funny, just a couple years ago, something like that would have scared the crap out of me.
Oh my god.
These days, I'm at, like, the collegiate level of not giving any fucks.
Oh god, okay. That was crazy. Actually, though. Well.
Need my DVD from Steph.
Okay.
I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Let's talk to you, Victoria. She looks so much younger. It's crazy. What the hell?
Victoria Chase. I'd rather vomit razor blades than talk to
her. Oh my god, girl. Don't even not vomit. What? Okay, I don't even want to have a mental picture of that either.
Carrie Price.
Carrie Price?
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing.
What the hell?
People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
Oh my god.
You don't say.
She's like the
Between
exact
same. That and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
Rachel Amber, Vortex Club.
Wow. The Young Artist Award.
Oh, it's not a big deal or anything. Like, 100 people submitted work, and my photography won.
Congrats, I guess.
So the Beacon's putting me up on the front page of the lifestyle section. Who cares?
Okay, way to bloat, whatever.
What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time
we
of your lives.
That.
Do tell.
It was fun. We murdered a man, oh my god.
It was a pretty normal night
we
for
did.
Us. A little music,
yeah,
a little dancing.
Pretty normal.
We murdered a guy.
You are so funny.
We're serious.
Oh, seriously, though. I didn't realize you and Rachel were such BFFs.
We're the best of friends.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure
oh
if
God.
She's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
That's so rude.
Seriously, I don't know
you
why you're
bitch.
Talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber.
Yep,
that's what's happening right now.
Literally, though. Makes sense.
Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you.
You're being you, too.
I'm sorry,
being so mean
Victoria.
To us for no reason.
I didn't mean to be rude. You know, I finished the assignment. Want some help?
You? Help me?
Yeah,
of course.
We are. So
that last
helpful.
Problem was hard, right? If I'm remembering correctly, the answer was fluorine, uranium,
oh God, what?
Carbon, potassium, and uranium again. Does that sound right?
Perfect. Hey,
oh,
thanks, Carrie.
Wrote that down. What
no
the hell?
Problem.
Take our word for it, why don't ya? What the hell? Very sabotaged, we're doing. Okay, let's go talk to the Steph person, which I think, no, right there, they're right there, but those are the people that, what the hell is going on over there? Are those people? Oh, that's a bus stop, right? What the fuck? Okay. Here's this guy, Evan! We talked to him as Max before, too.
Evan.
Oh my god.
Amazing photographer, but such a bleeding heart. What soapbox is he on today?
Oh God, let's see.
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans.
Oh God,
that's a record high and completely preventable.
Especially in Oregon, my God. And anywhere, honestly, but Jesus. Wildfires are awesome. They're not awesome.
This is for college, right?
What the hell?
I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone.
Well, makes sense.
Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic.
Oh my God, we don't know her that well yet.
I bet she'd be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess.
Go ask her yourself. Oh my God, wildfires are awesome, I guess.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
Oh no.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
I got it.
Wait, one last thing.
That's so funny.
Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Principal Dix? What the hell? Sure, why not?
Sure. I love assemblies. Fires, so. Some of the best naps of my life.
Oh my God.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Why not?
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
No, right? Okay. Let me sign the fucking paper.
How seriously am I taking this right now?
Evanus and Ass Clown Smokeweed.dbear. Let's just be serious.
There you go. Just don't expect this to become a habit.
Yeah, everyone else.
Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
Oh yeah. Principal Dix, big McHuge balls. What the fuck is wrong with people? This is like, make it so like, there's no wildfires.
What? Caring about important issues?
Caring in general.
I do care. I mean, maybe Chloe doesn't care that much, but I made her care, so. Alright, let's get to these. Steph and Mikey. We're gonna have to read about them in a second, but...
Steph Gingrich and Mikey North, Blackwell's premier indoor kids.
Let's talk to them first.
Steph has created something of a business selling pirated DVDs to other students.
Makes sense.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
Oh,
it was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Game. Try me. I used to play. I guess you probably used to play.
I used to play with my friend Max.
Oh, wow. Really? Oh,
it's
God.
Been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
We need our DVD
One
right
Blade
now.
Runner. Director's cut coming
Blade
right
Runner?
Up.
Oh, my God.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Oh my God.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Yeah.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Oh my, why is
Rachel
everyone asking about her?
Amber?
Jesus.
You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
We're not friends. What's it to you?
Why do you want to know?
She's our friend.
Steph has a crush.
Oh, she's a crush.
Chloe,
maker?
You should join her game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right
50
now.
50 hours? Oh
Thanks,
my
though.
God.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take like 20 minutes. What else have you got to do before class?
Sure, no way, some other time. Oh my God, fine, I guess so.
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
I've seen people do this before in this game.
Here's
and
a character
I was like,
sheet.
I'm gonna skip that, but I'll do
you
it.
You are an elf barbarian.
Oh no. Why is that funny? I'm totally an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know, I'm good.
Yeah.
All right, let's get started. You are both famous
I'm
heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land. Now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black
Well. Oh my God,
well,
this is intense.
Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps,
seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
What the hell are you guys talking about? What the hell?
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay.
Alright.
I'm an elf barbarian named,
Calamastia Chloe Barb? Barb? What the hell? We're not Barb right now, we're Calamastia.
Calamastia.
Yeah. What's wrong with that?
Super into it.
Not bad. Yeah.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
According to my character sheet, I once made a man kebab.
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, God. And it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
He looks scared.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the dude.
Dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Surely.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Warlord's tent, training ground, prison camp, leave the game. Leave the game. Yeah, I'm gonna leave the fucking game. Fuck you all. What about the tents, maybe? Or the prison? I don't know.
It's tent time.
Time to
Are you sure you want to skip the training ground and the prison camp?
Oh, that's a bottle? I mean, what? Battle? Let me pick again, actually.
Okay, let me pick again.
Where do you wish to go?
The prison camp.
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay.
Probably little dragon people.
Hey, shitface!
Oh, okay.
Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
You have any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Intimidate. Tempt with bread? That is so funny. Oh my god, I'm so tempted to do that.
Apparently, I have bread. I try to tempt the little bastard out with it.
He sticks out his tongue, finding your offering disgusting.
Bread is disgusting, honestly. Okay, let's intimidate.
Intimidate.
I guess.
That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
Oh god.
You can try.
Chloe is scary.
What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't.
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Oh
shit.
My god.
Really?
Now he can understand
this
every word you
for
say.
Me.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge. Where you try to use...
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
Oh,
he steps back,
God.
His scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
Dragons are pussies.
Everybody knows that
dragons
are pussies.
Oh, I already did
pussies.
It wrong.
That's why they hide in caves and only come out to
God
breathe
damn it.
Fire
I didn't
on
mean to
sheep
do that.
And eat cows and shit.
What?
That was a mistake. The dragonkin growls, snapping at you and showing his teeth and claws. Tall one is a fool. Dragons are gods, he says.
Oh,
damn.
No. Can we make a taller?
You're short, I
oh,
say.
Oh, okay.
But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear
this
it as a top
confusing,
hat. Then you'd
like,
be way taller.
I don't know.
No, no, please don't do that. Still, I cannot give key. Durgaron will eat me.
I think he's close to breaking.
Pull out your stomach, grab the key, taste my axe.
I show him my fist. I call this the Ripper, because it's
reaching
down dragonkin throats and ripping out dragonkin stomachs.
Dragonkin cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws, and you think he's about to yell for help.
Oh my god.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go.
She's taking this really seriously.
The next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a +10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll.
What the fuck?
A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
What, it dies of
fear?
Oh my
God. Team. Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
Oh no, okay, I guess training grounds now.
That sounds good. Let's go to the training ground.
Sweet.
Upon arriving at the training ground, you are spotted by a heavy-set orc who immediately shouts and points. There are a dozen raiders on the training field, all of whom raise their weapons and charge.
Okay. So what do we do?
I cast Urgul's Acid Blast.
Oh, God.
Overkill?
Bam!
You conjure up a wave of acid that washes over the charging orcs. Every raider suddenly starts screaming and writhing in pain. There's a sweet and sour kind of smell as the flesh melts off their bones like warm candle wax.
Holy shit.
I haven't really needed a partner?
The heavy-set orc sergeant still remains. He runs at you, swinging a massive warhammer.
All yours.
Knee slam, pommel, what was that?
I do a pommel strike. I strike his pommel hard.
What is a pommel?
What did I say?
A pommel is the end of a sword handle. Pommel strike is where you hit the guy with it.
Ah.
What?
Damn it. Okay, I do that.
Except you're not wielding a sword, you're wielding an axe.
This sucks.
How am I supposed to know any of that?
Try using your.
You've delayed too long. The orc swings his warhammer at your head, barely missing. Your move.
Okay, full knee slam.
I knee him. Right in the orc balls.
Oh, shit.
Success. The orc clutches his groin, never to father children again.
Oh, my God. That's so terrible.
Your turn again, Chloe.
Okay, let's end this. Fatal cleave.
You swing your great axe downward with both hands. The orc blinks, then splits open like a hot dog bun.
Oh, my God.
Fuck yeah. I'm awesome at this game.
It's going well.
What about the loot?
Well, as the training ground is now a roiling pit of acid, it's unlikely any loot survived.
Dang.
So no loot? Wow.
My character raises her axe. You'll pay for ruining all that loot, Elamon.
Oh, we're going after him.
By my honor, I apologize. Here, take this potion as a gift.
Thanks, dude.
Potion? Okay, we got candy.
What's next?
I guess. Okay. Warlord's
It's tent time.
Finally, last
you
one.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, Warlord of the Raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily
so
6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah ha ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
Oh.
What an asshole.
Yeah, what an asshole.
This.
What the hell?
I cast Zael's Cataclysmic Cone of Fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgeron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Except for, you know, Acid Blast, which someone used unnecessarily to show off for Chloe. Calamastia? What'll it be?
Annihilation Strike, Brutal Punch, Wraithful Rush. What about this one?
Holy shit! Annihilation Strike! That sounds boss as fuck!
One?
One?
That's bad, right?
Is it bad?
Not for me.
Oh no.
As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble.
No! Are we dying?
Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no. Three.
What?
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs. Plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
Oh my god.
I am so sorry.
Durgeron moves toward the crippled Elamon.
Wow.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgeron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do?
Is it, dance? Encourage Elamon? Jump in front of... Okay, let's jump in front of...
Jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
What the hell?
Okay. Durgeron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Oh, no.
Shit!
Oh, no.
What?
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails.
Oh, we didn't dodge
Durgeron
it. Oh,
laughs
no.
As he impales you on his blade,
did
lifting you high into the air.
I fucked this
Seriously?
Up.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off.
Oh my.
We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgeron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
Swing for his head, swing for his arm.
I take one last swing at Durface's head.
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
Oh no.
Come on.
11.
Is it high enough?
You swing, catching Durgeron on the side of his head, severing one horn. But you don't do enough damage to kill him.
What an
Fuck.
Asshole!
He laughs, then rips you off his sword with a vicious jerk.
Oh my.
You die.
Okay,
painfully.
I ended up, apparently.
So mean.
I'm sorry, Chloe. I have to escape.
Hey, man.
Escape without
feet?
Can. What the hell?
Do it.
I cast Warden's Hideaway.
You sure?
It's all I've got.
You summon a spectral door, which shields you from Durgeron. Light flares out, blinding him. The door swings shut, then disappears. You are gone from sight and cannot be harmed.
Oh my god.
I guess I'll have to come back when I'm stronger.
That was fun.
Yeah, actually.
Check out what I drew.
I died though. I'm really sad about it.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Wow. That's really cool, actually. Oh my god. That's really cool.
Sorry I died and left you out there to fend for yourself.
It's cool. I'll get him. Eventually.
Wow. I mean,
glad
we
you
risked
enjoyed
our life
it,
for
Chloe.
Him and died, but...
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
Woo!
We'll see.
See you later, nerds. Right?
Thanks for the game, nerds.
We count as a nerd, too, apparently, because we just did that shit, so...
DVD, check. Next
that
up,
was crazy.
Chemistry class.
Oh my
joy.
God.
Joy.
Okay, totally joy. Alright, we read all that. Let's read the author now, especially since we just did that all. Okay, has kissed girls, has not kissed ever. What the hell? I can never decide if Steph's the coolest or nerdiest person in all of Blackwell. Maybe both. She's definitely queen of the indoor kids with all their weird role-playing games and sci-fi shit. I guess her dad is a video editor. She makes some sweet cash by selling bootleg DVDs. Don't knock the hustle. I'm pretty sure Steph does all the backstage techno work with the school plays, which checks out. Another thing about Steph's nothing about Steph. She's into girls, and she doesn't give a shit what anyone else thinks about it. That's awesome, though. I mean, it's kind of like Chloe, right? Not yet, though. Mikey North is the captain of Steph's fan club, and the two of them can be found huddled around the tables rolling 20-sided dice whenever they have the chance. If life were on the side on those 80s movies Dad used to watch, Mikey would be the nerd that the jocks give wedgies to. In the real world, if someone messed with Mikey, they'd be in dipshit. Mikey's older brother and Drew is Drew North, Blackwell's alpha jock. Sixth level flaming gauntlet of awesomeness. The truth is, Mikey is one of the few genuinely nice people in this net place. Although every once in a while, he says something that reveals a darker outlook in life. No idea where he gets it from. Maybe Star Trek? Wow, that was an interesting game to play, honestly. I actually kind of enjoyed it. I thought I wouldn't enjoy it, but it was really interesting, so I'm glad I played it instead of not. So yeah, can we have one more girl to talk over and then go into the school hopefully, and then I'll end the part here. There, I mean, Samantha. Okay.
Samantha Myers. Never seen her. Wallflower. She could give you a run for your money, Max.
Oh, she's like Max. Maybe that's why we didn't see her in the game. That's interesting. Okay, let's talk.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Hi.
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
Oh?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
Interesting. What did you like about it? She's a nerd. We already know that. It's sad, it's funny.
The story is about how relationships work if people are willing to lie to each other.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe.
Oh!
No one says anything like that.
Girl, what?
I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
Oh my god, you're tripping me out.
I bet.
What the hell? Okay. Anything else? I don't think there's anything else, actually. Except for flowers, apparently.
Flowers always make me think of springtime, which makes me think of summer, which makes me think of getting the fuck away from Blackwell for 3 whole months. I love flowers.
Me too. I love flowers. They're so pretty. Anything else we can do? Oh yeah, there's money in here, right? Pretty sure there is. Can we not put any in here? Or we can look at it, though, actually.
The future needs excellence.
Oh, yeah.
The future is an asshole.
The things we know about the future is it really does make an asshole, honestly. Goddamn. Anything else we need to do? I don't think there's anything else outside, so I think we can go inside now. Let's get going. She really doesn't want to go in there. Oh!
What the hell?
Oh my god. Is that Nathan?
What have you got here?
It is!
Twitch? Don't call me that!
True North.
Oh, not Nathan.
The jock's so dumb, he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Nathan's
thing
is literally killing Chloe.
This is some really weird crap,
in the very
Prescott.
Beginning of the first game.
It's not yours.
So,
give it back! I hate
really
that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
I don't think I want to defend him, honestly. You're the both losers. Take it elsewhere. I don't know what to say. Nathan is weird, but he also has problems. So I don't know what to say.
Want to take this elsewhere, guys?
The mute speaks?
No, we're not in mutes. Don't bully us,
Max.
Whoa, next.
Whoa.
What the hell, bro?
You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition.
Oh, okay, that's so
How much
mean.
Financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
That's too far. Oh
wow.
My god.
Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard. When your dad
I'm
closed it down.
Side, so
and you
want
to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone.
Girl, no.
You know something, Prescott?
Nathan's not my
I'm
bitch.
I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
He was part of the team? What the hell? That's so weird.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill
you.
Stop
it! That hits home. I'm going to kill you. Like, God.
Chloe, do something!
Leave me alone! I'm not doing it.
If you don't take the time to stand back and watch, you miss some of life's finer moments.
Just do it, honestly. Like, Nathan killed Chloe in the first game. I can't. Like, in the very first scene.
That
almost
took me
first
months
scene.
To put together.
Quit the team, Twitch. Or next time it'll be worse.
Oh my God. He's getting hardcore bullied right now.
Go to hell.
The guy's gone through so much, but also, like, he literally murders Chloe in one of the first scenes. So, what does this bitch want from me?
You should be ashamed.
Girl, you should be ashamed defending a murderer. But okay. What the hell? I feel kind of bad, but also not really. Because, like, God. Our mom messaged us. Oh, I got Nathan and Drew. One second. Let's look at mom's messages real quick. I don't like how we left things. We'll talk more tonight. Perfect. Is that a sarcastic perfect? No. Okay, we can read these. Nathan, Drew North is Mikey's older brother. Oh, that's his older brother. Oh my God, okay. And the two of them couldn't be more different. Drew is a legit jock, like the type of that spends hours a day in the gym. Has nicknames for his biceps. I've never been to a Big Fist game, but I hear he's actually really good at throwing stuff into each other. Or whatever. goes in. Oh my. Okay. No. Mikey told me that Drew is planning to go to college on an athletic scholarship, which is good because their family is even poorer than mine. Their dad was on the fisherman who, one of the fishermen who lost his job because of the Prescott Corporation. As you might imagine, this put Nathan on Drew's shit list. Not a good list to be on. In the war between the what the fuck does that say? Meathead, okay. And the shithead, does anyone win? Anyway, I don't think Drew's really a bad guy, but I guess I wouldn't know. It's like we exist in two different, completely different planes of existence. That happens to be the same school. Happy to keep it that way. Okay, and then we got Nathan. Nope, that's not Nathan. What? Right there. Nathan Prescott is the golden child of the Prescotts. God, we know. He literally murdered Chloe in the very almost first scene of the game. Like, I don't think I like Nathan. Like, I'm sorry, but Chloe's my favorite character. Arcadia Bay's oldest, wealthiest, and most powerful family, as they love reminding everyone. Yep. Nathan's dad does something nautical related. I think it has to do with murdering baby seals and turning them into death rays for the military. But I can't remember the details. Whatever the case, here's a lot. There's a lot of people in this town who hates the Prescotts, including all the fishermen he put out of work. And you do not want to mess with the fishermen. They smell. Nathan is odd. He's extremely privileged, yet dark and brooding, even though he's a dick. I can't help feeling bad for him sometimes. He's really just a weird little dude trying to figure out his shit. But he has to pretend to be all this stuff. He's clearly not. Like an athlete or a cool kid, you can tell he fucks him up inside. Of course, the best cure for feeling bad for Nathan is to actually talk to Nathan. Then you remember he that would have wonderfully punchable face that his Prescott's genes gave him. I guess so, yeah. Wow, we've almost met everyone. Oh, there's two people in that one. Oh my God. I wonder who that is, the two people. Then there's like people right here. Okay. Alright, let's get into the school.
I would sacrifice a goat to Jeremiah Blackwell himself.
Oh my God.
I'd be leaving here in a month.
Damn, girl. Okay. Let's get inside the school and then leave the game.
That pick would actually make a sweet tattoo.
Marijuana cigarettes kill? Is that a tattoo she gets? I don't remember.
Maybe if I delay going inside long enough, Blackwell will be overrun by future excellence. And by future excellence, I mean mole people.
Yeah. I don't want to go in. Oh my God. Okay. Wow, everyone. Oh. Oh my God.
Oh, good. You're here.
Maybe we don't go yet. Oh, we do go. Okay. I hope you guys all enjoyed my first part of my Life is Strange playthrough. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. I definitely enjoyed it so much. It's such an amazing game so far. I love Chloe so much. She's so fun, but really fun. She's so funny and really sad. And it just is such a sad situation to play a character that's lost their father and like going through like a whole bunch of shit in her mind, and also having to deal with like, and, you know, having a new like dad type thing or something. I don't know. But yeah. And Max also being gone, not messing her back, her only friend. Goddamn. We did meet Rachel Amber in the beginning, which is awesome, but I think now we're gonna talk to her, but that's gonna be for part two. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. Bye guys.